Hi guys, this is Sushant Kochar. Today we are going to talk about a few varieties of ghee that are usually produced nowadays and how they can be a bit different. Ghee is produced from milk. Nowadays a famous method is to get cream out of raw milk. There are machines that do it. So you use that cream to make ghee out of it. Otherwise you boil the milk and then you get the layer of fat on top of that milk, which is known as malai, and then you get ghee out of that malai. The third one is to make dahi from milk, and blending that dahi to do bilona of that dahi, blending that dahi, the curd, dahi is curd, so blending that curd to get butter out of it, and then getting ghee out of that butter. Now, so nowadays you might have heard or seen that ghee gets to stink after 3 or 4 months. This may be because the method of making ghee that our ancestors have been using was making it by blending curd and then getting butter and then making it from that butter. So nowadays people are using these two methods, where they would use malai or cream to make that ghee. Now this cream has been taken out from raw milk. This milk has not been boiled. Now this malai has been taken out from boiled milk, but this the liquid part of that milk has not been blended to get this malai. While in the case of curd, we would blend the liquid part of the milk. So when you blend the curd, there can be some constituent parts from the liquid portion of the milk, of the curd, that come to the top along with the butter. So which would not be the case in case of malai or cream. So you would not get, you might not get some constituent parts of the curd when you do not blend it. Okay, so Ayurveda says that the older the ghee, the better the ghee. So basically, if you have 100 years old ghee, then it is like 100 times better, or a lot of times better than a freshly made ghee. And nowadays a lot of people are using fridge to keep ghee. There is no necessity for keeping ghee in fridge. You can keep ghee in airtight containers of glass, a container where there is no passage of air. Keeping the ghee in fridge can make ghee soak the soak some of the harmful gases of fridge. So you do not want to keep it in the refrigerator. The reason the ghee stinks after 3 or 4 months could be that it is not being made by its ideal method, which is making it from curd by blending it, or it can be that the hormones are injected into the cows which come to the milk and then further into the ghee. But this might not be the case, because where from the place I buy ghee, they make it from cream and they do not inject cows, but still it stinks. So then there can be another reason, that the cows are being fed the grass or the food which comes from a soil where industries or factories might have dumped their chemicals, so that those chemicals go into the soil and then they further come into the grass and then again to the person or the animal who eats that grass. So that those chemicals might be a reason for short lifespan of today's ghee. Now what I wanted to convey in this video is that the ghee that you get from these three methods might not exactly work same in your body, because this ghee was formed from raw milk without boiling it. This one was formed by boiling milk but without blending the whole milk. This one was made by blending the whole content of the milk in the form of curd. So the ideal method should be what our ancestors were using, which was blending the curd, getting butter out of it, and then making ghee out of it. So I would say we should go with that method. All of these ghees might not exactly work same in our bodies, because the preparation methods were not same. Now if you talk about calories, the calories would be same in all the cases, the fat content would be same in all the cases as per the science, but they might not work same in the body. And the reason that today's ghee is not long lasting. Could be that the formation procedure is not the right one, maybe, or maybe that the cow's food is contaminated with chemicals. So if you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.